Holiness is not in things, but in the mind. Bread is just bread, yet through bread God reveals God's self to me. Bread is on sale in the stores. It is given away freely in restaurants. It is tossed to birds in the park. Yet through bread Christ reveals his presence. God is the creator of the common. God uses the common to commune with creation. God uses the common to communicate with creation. The immaterial God is known through material things. Bread and wine and water, oil and the printed page, everyday speech in the common tongue, the extraordinary bursting from the ordinary. The earth and the things within it are not the means of communication. They are the communication. Life is not the forum for blessing. Life is the blessing. The proof that I am blessed is that I exist. I am the image of God in a world where God continually calls to me, hoping to get my attention. Life itself has become sacramental. All things, no matter how common, are sacraments. All things, no matter how mundane, are holy. For it is through all things that God speaks, and God's presence is known. Just as I handle the Eucharistic bread with reverence, just as I demonstrate respect for the consecrated host, just as I receive the bread with gratitude and joy, I am learning to handle all things in this life and in this world with reverence, respect, gratitude, and joy. For God is in the midst of all things, and Christ is present with me always, and the Holy Spirit allows a simple action, as mundane as the gentle blowing of the wind, to be divine revelation and divine speech. The path to God is the path of the ordinary. It is in the least of these where Christ is found. Love is the food for the soul. Acts of love are fruit from the tree of life. I have not lost the Garden of Eden through sin. I have only lost my ability to see it. Love corrects my vision. Love blocks the blinding glare of sin, leaving only paradise in my view. The entire garden was perfect for Adam and Eve, but they dwelled on the tiny bit of imperfection. They stopped seeing the garden and only saw the serpent. They forgot the 99 trees from which they could eat and only focused on the one that was forbidden to them. The presence of the serpent shows that the garden was not perfect, but it was perfect for them, and they traded that perfection for imperfection because they lost sight of the holiness all around them. God did not go anywhere. They just stopped looking. And after they sinned and remembered to look back to God, they were afraid and saw only punishment, because that is what fear sees, punishment. But love removes fear of punishment, and love itself becomes punishment to the unloving. A sacrament is a visible sign of an invisible grace. Therefore, this breath I breathe is a sacrament. For it is not of my doing, and I cannot keep it when it goes. This life is a sacrament, for I did not choose to have existence. I did not choose the family I had, but they were all given to me by God. The people I encounter each day are sacraments, for they are the hands and voice of God. This body I have is a sacrament, for it nourishes my soul. All material things are holy and sacramental, and I will learn to be gentle with all things, as if I am holding something priceless in my hands. I will learn to treat all things with respect, reverence, gratitude, and joy. Life itself is the sacrament. The bread and the wine are food for the journey.